Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today, in video 10 of chapter our unit 12, aldehyde, ketones, and carboxylic acid, we are going to discuss about the physical properties of aldehyde and ketone. Now, in these physical properties, we are going to discuss about three aspects. What we say? The first one we are going to discuss is about physical state. Physical state means solid, liquid, and gas. Okay. Second, we are going to discuss is about boiling point. Boiling point. Okay. And the third we are going to discuss is about solubility. Clear? So these three aspects we are going to discuss in our topic, that is physical properties of aldehyde, ketones, and carboxylic acid. Now, when we talk about physical state, we are going to discuss about the first aspect. When we talk about physical state, methanol is a gas. The word what we say? Methanol. Methanol means formula is HCHO. Methanol is the state when we say, we are talking about the physical state. The state is gaseous state. And when we talk about ethanol, ethanol, that is CH3CHO, is a volatile liquid. Here, so we came to know here which are the two states, that is methanol is a gas and ethanol is a volatile liquid at the main word is at room temperature. Clear? Now this was all about the state which is given in your textbook. In your textbook it is given on page 365. You can see that methanol is a gas at room temperature and ethanol is a volatile liquid. Other aldehyde and ketones are liquid or solid at room temperature. Now when we talk about other aldehyde and ketones are liquid. The word is what given? Other means methanol, ethanol is given. So after that what comes? Propanol, butanol and ketones when we say, most of that. It is at a liquid or solid. Liquid or solid at room temperature. Room temperature. Understood? So here we have finished about the physical state of methanol. Understood? It is given in your textbook. You can see the first two lines it is given. Methanol is a gas at room temperature. Methanol. Ethanol is a volatile liquid. And the other, what we say? Other means propanol and remaining ketones, what we say? They are what we call it as solid or liquid at a room temperature. Understood? Now the second aspect, that is what the boiling point that we are going to discuss. Now, when we see the second aspect, that is the boiling point when we talk about, in your book, there is a tabular form given. In your book, it is given like this. The first one they have given is N-butane. What is given? N-butane. Second one, it is given as methoxy. What is the word? Methoxyethane. Clear? Third one, they have given as propanol. Propanol. Fourth one, they have given as acetone. And the fifth one they have given as propane-1-OL. Understood? Propane-1-OL. Okay. So now in this case, these are the, what you call it as, the organic compounds which are given. Now based on that, they have given the boiling point. Now when we say the boiling point, it is given in kelvins, what we say. Clear? The first one they have given 273. Then second is 281. That is for methoxyethane. Now this is your ether. Ether, this is your hydrocarbon. Here, this is hydrocarbon. This is your aldehyde. This is your ketone. And this is alcohol. Okay? So, these five of the things are given. What we say, the boiling points are also given. You can see here, this is for a propanol, it is given 322. 322. Acetone, it is given 329. And what you call it as propanol, it is given 370. Now if you see in this case, the highest
the highest boiling point is of what you call it as alcohol. Clear? The reason for this is the intermolecular. What is the word? Intermolecular hydrogen bond. What is the word? Intermolecular hydrogen bond between the molecules. This is the reason for alcohol to have the highest boiling point. Now, when we talk about this one, that is in this case, hydrocarbon butane, so we can write for that, that is weak van der Waals forces. Clear? So weak van der Waals forces are there, so boiling point will be least, what we call, less. Then when we talk about what I call propanol, acetone and all are given. Huh? So here, if you see in aldehyde and ketone, there is an absence. What is the word? Absence of hydrogen bonding. Clear? So that's why compared to alcohol, their boiling point are less. When we talk about this hydrocarbon and all, ether or hydrocarbon, when we talk about hydrocarbon, weak van der Waals forces are there. While in this case, when we compare, that is when we compare aldehyde and ketone. Clear? So aldehyde and ketone, you will see there are dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole interaction between molecules. Clear? Compared to hydrocarbons. Understood? So due to more dipole-dipole interaction in aldehyde and ketone compared to hydrocarbon, you can say that aldehyde and ketones boiling points, what we say, are more compared to that of the hydrocarbon. When we talk about alcohol, alcohol has what you call it as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. While when we compare aldehyde and ketone with alcohol, so there is an absence of what we call it as hydrogen bond in aldehyde and ketone compared to alcohol. So like this, all boiling points are explained in this. Now the next. So when we compare here, when we compare of ether with aldehyde and ketone, when we say, in this case ether will have less dipole-dipole interaction compared to aldehyde and ketone. That's why if you see aldehyde and ketone compared to ether, their boiling points are higher, while of ether it is less. Reason is what? Now ether, when we write like this, CH3O CH2 CH3, like this. Okay, so this is the formula for methoxy ethane. When we talk about aldehyde, it is CH3C double bond O and H, like this. Understood? So in this case, I think it is given propanol. So I will take three carbons here, CH2 and C double bond O and H. Okay. So when we say here delta plus and here delta minus, this is the dipole-dipole interaction, what we said. Now that is, here it is there, but the ion aldehyde, it is more compared to that of ether, what we call. Understood? Ether also, electron pair will be moving towards where? Towards oxygen. Oxygen is more electronegative. So here delta plus, here also delta plus, it will be here delta plus, like this we can write. So in this case, when we say here, when we talk about this dipole-dipole interaction is less compared to that of aldehyde. That's why ether is having low boiling point compared to that of aldehyde and ketone. Understood this part? So this is the thing what you have to remember. When we talk about butane, why it is less? Because of weak van der Waals forces. Understood? When we talk about ether, the less dipole moment compared to dipole-dipole interaction of aldehyde and ketone. When we talk about alcohol, alcohol has more hydrogen bonding compared to that of aldehyde and ketone. Here there is an absence of H bond. So these are the physical properties what we have discussed for boiling point of aldehyde and ketone. Physical state we already discussed. Now the last aspect, that is the solubility, we are going to discuss. Just a minute. Now the third aspect what we are going to discuss is about solubility. Now when we talk about solubility, what we say, in this case you will see that is the lower, what we call it as, that is the lower members of aldehyde and ketone such as methanol, ethanol and propanol. What is the word? Lower members. The word is what? Lower members of aldehyde and ketones. Here, now when we say lower members means up to 1, 2 or 3 carbons. That is, in your book they have given example of methanol. Clear? Methanol, ethanol and propanol. Clear? So here one carbon, here two carbon, and here three carbon. This is your ketone. Clear? This is your aldehyde, and this is also aldehyde.
So the word is what? The lower members of aldehyde and ketone, such as methanol, what we say, ethanol and propanol, form intermolecular.
What they form? They form intermolecular hydrogen bond with water molecule. With a water molecule. Therefore, they are miscible. Miscible means simple word soluble. Miscible in water. Understood? Now, what is the meaning of that intermolecular hydrogen bonding means what? Now, suppose if I write like this, ethanol I take. So, CH3C double bond O and X I will write here. Otherwise, we will write in different way. C double bond O and H. Okay? So, this is your what we call it as ethanol. What is this? Ethanol. Ethanol with a water molecule. When we say water molecule, I will draw like this. Clear? Water molecule. So, ethanol forms a hydrogen bond with water molecule. So, in this case, another molecule I will take. C, CH3 and H. So, here I will draw the hydrogen bond with a dotted red line like this. Can you see here? So, they form a hydrogen bond like this with water, water molecule. This is your water molecule. This is your water molecule. Okay? So, it forms a hydrogen bond with water molecule due to which they are miscible. If you don't know the word miscible, the synonym for that is soluble. What is the synonym? It is the same word for miscible is soluble. So, why are these lower alkanes soluble in water? Because of formation of hydrogen bond with water, what we said here. Okay? Water molecule. Understood this part? So, this is about what we call it as the solubility part. But now, when the number of carbon increases, that is what? This is higher than this, higher than 3 when we said. That is, if I take butanol, that is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH1. Now, this is what? Butanol. Okay, so this butanol means a higher member. What is the word? Higher member of aldehyde or ketone. When the number of carbon increases, the solubility decreases. That is, the number of alkyl groups keep, that is, number of carbon keep on increasing, the solubility keeps on decreasing. Understood this part? So, this was all about solubility. In your textbook, I think it is given in the last paragraph, you can just see. That the solubility increase with increase in the alkyl group or the chain, what we say. Understood? So, this was all about solubility and everything what we say. The questions can be asked in your exam, that is, list the physical properties of aldehyde and ketone. It can be asked for 3 marks. What is the question? List the physical properties of aldehyde and ketone. For 3 marks it can be asked. So, in that all 3 aspects you have to cover. The first aspect what we saw was physical state. Okay, second aspect we called is boiling point, and the third aspect what we discuss is what we call it as solubility. Understood? So, all these 3 things with an example you have to write for 3 marks what we call. Understood? So, this was all about the physical properties. Now, in your book one question is given, that is in textual example 12.2. Now, that can also be asked for 2 marks what we say, that we are going to discuss next. Okay, just a minute. Now, the question what is asked in your book is arranged in the increasing order of their boiling point, what is given. Increasing order of their boiling point. So, first of all, whenever this type of questions are asked, we have seen that table which was given in your textbook. So, first of all, I will separate this into, this one is what? Butane, or we can also write it as hydrocarbon. This one is your hydrocarbon, this is your alcohol, this one is ether. And this one, what we say, this is your aldehyde, alcohol, ether, and this is your hydrocarbon, clear, carbon. Now, whenever we talk about increasing order, what is the word? Increasing order means smaller value of boiling point to greater value. Greater value or we can also say it as higher value of a boiling point. Understood?
So now last time what we have discussed in that, we know that alcohol have the highest boiling point. So
when we say here alcohol will come at the end, but when we talk about increasing order, no, always remember less than sign you have to use. Understood? So highest out of this all is what? The alcohol, right here, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. So what will be the reason for this? That is the intermolecular H bond, hydrogen bond is the reason for the, what I call it as highest will come at the end. I will change this so that it will be easier. CH3, CH2, 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 OH, like this. So, because due to intermolecular H bond. Okay, this is the reason why it is highest.
Increasing order it is. Which order? Increasing. So the highest value will come last and the lowest value will come first. So lowest value will be of hydrocarbon. That is
CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. That is what you call it as hydrocarbon, what we say. But now here what is the reason? So we can write weak van der Waals force. What is the word? Weak van der Waals force. This of attraction. Okay, due to which the boiling point will be missed. Then after what we have seen, if after that what will come? Ether will come. What will come? Ether. Ether means I write C2H5 diethyl ether. This is what? This is your diethyl ether. Understood? So when we say who will come first in this order, second will be diethyl ether because less dipole interaction between molecules here compared to aldehyde CH3 CH2 CH2 CHO. So I can write here higher dipole interaction between molecules. Clear? So when we say the order, so this is the reason why this order I have written like this. The reason for the list here is weak van der Waals force, after that less dipole-dipole interaction compared to that of aldehyde absence of hydrogen bond compared to alcohol. So here that also you can write, or between these two if you compare you can write this part also. So this was all about what we call the question which was asked based on the physical property, and that is boiling point. Okay. Now the next what we say is your in-text question. In-text question 12.3. It is given on textbook page number 366. In this also same it is, arrange the following in what we call it as the increasing order. In-text question it is given here. Arrange the following component increasing order of their boiling point. So they have given them CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, OH, CH3, O, CH3 and CH3, CH2, CH3. Now when we talk about increasing order, means the one which is the least will come first. So first what I write, the hydrocarbon, that is CH3, CH2, CH3. Then less than second one will come ether, that is CH3, O, CH3. Then next will come aldehyde, that is CH3, CHO. And the last one will be alcohol, CH3, CH2, OH. Understood? So this is based on what we have already discussed. Here, weak van der Waals force. Here, less dipole-dipole interaction between compared to aldehyde. And here, presence of hydrogen bond. So like this, you can write the increasing order. Always remember, increasing order means less than sign. And the one which is the least boiling point will be written first. And the one with the maximum boiling point will be written at last, what we say. So remember this thing and don't get confused in increasing order and decreasing order. Understood? So here we come to an end of this video. In the next video, we will be continuing with chemical properties or chemical reaction of aldehydes and ketones. We are going to discuss in the next videos. Okay? Thank you very much.